Got myself a lot of gear today. It's all for a reason, and we'll get to that in a second. Whew, a little warmer than I thought. Bill here for another TV photog tip. I got a little bit of gear here, and the reason for all this is because today we are talking about depth of field. Oh, I am sweaty. It has been, I'm a little behind this week shooting my tips because it's been cold and rainy all week. I suppose it is September, so it is getting cooler out. But I decided I'm going to go out to the park here. We're going to talk about depth of field. Now I know the more you do this, I've been doing this for 25 years, there's a lot of things that just kind of come naturally after doing it time after time after time. So what is depth of field? Depth of field is how much is in focus from your subject. So you have something in focus, how much is in focus in front and how much is in focus in back, but what is your target, your subject in focus. And so there are three things that affect depth of field. That is how close you are to the subject, your focal length, or which is the lens length or how much you're zoomed in, and the aperture or the f-stop. How wide your iris is. Is it going to be small or is it going to be big? So for demonstration purposes, I set up this little, setup here. The way all this is going to work is up here in the front, this is going to be my foreground. So what's going to be up close. Back here, this is going to be my main subject. So this one I'm going to focus on. I'm going to use this light stand because it shows the most detail. And then, of course, in the back is going to be even more depth is that other orange bucket back there. And of course we got the tree line and everything else, so you can see the different levels here. So the first one is your distance, how close you are to the subject. If you ever look at the focus ring on a lens, if you notice the little markers, there's more or less distance in between the different markers. So when you go to the infinity marker, which looks like a number 8 on its side, that handles a lot of distance. That has a lot of distance. Meanwhile, on the other end, your 1 foot, 2 foot, 3 foot, there's a bit of a gap between that. So that's one way to think about how close or far away you get. Shows how close you are to the object with the focus determines depth of field. Okay, the next thing we're going to talk about is the focal length, or how much you're zoomed in, so your lens. So I know I don't have a professional grade camera here, this is my vlogging camera, but basically the more you're zoomed in to subject, the more narrow your depth of field gets. The more you're zoomed out, the wider it gets. Third thing that affects depth of field is the size of your aperture or your f-stop. So I sometimes get this backwards and confused when I try to explain it, but when it's a 1 or a 2, you get a wider iris, which lets in more light, but you get a shallower depth of field. If you have like 11 or a 16, you get a smaller aperture, lets in less light, but you get a greater depth of field. So it's a lot harder to do the F11 or 16 when it's dark or at night than it is during the day. Now let's put this all into practice now that I explained everything individually, because we learn from results. All right, so right now I'm a couple feet away from the foreground bucket. Of course, I'm focused on the middle light stand, and then you can see the bucket in the background. I'm on F11, and so you can pretty much see everything in focus. I'm going to change my aperture here. So now I'm on a 1.8, and you can see it kind of lets more light in. Can adjust for that. But I'm still focused on the middle thing here, but you can kind of see how out of focus the bucket became in the foreground, but it's still kind of readable. All right, now I've moved up closer to the foreground bucket. I'm focused still on the light stand. I'm on a F11, so small aperture, and so you can tell I got a pretty good depth of field here because you can read the bucket in the foreground and still see the light stand. Now I'm going to move my aperture, and I'm going to make that a 1.8. So now it's a wider iris, and you can see how out of focus the foreground went, but my light stand is still in focus. So I made myself a shallower depth of field. And for this one, I've actually moved farther away from the foreground bucket. I'm now like twice the distance I was originally, and I'm zoomed in and focused on the light stand, and you can kind of see how it's already knocked, the foreground is already knocked out of focus, and I'm still on a f11 iris, or aperture I should say. So now I'm going to move, well, iris, aperture, that's all the same thing. So now I'm moving to a 1.2, so a wide aperture f-stop iris. So of course, what are some of the practical uses for this? Well, one is on interviews. There's been plenty of times where I have been across the room on a good lens, zoomed in, and everything is just blown out and back. It's all out of focus except for the person that I'm interviewing or I'm shooting video of. And so that's great. At the same time, I can go get up close, zoom out wide, and I kind of have like a different, like a fisheye kind of a look sometimes. So it all depends on the look you're going for. Another practical thing is, like, let's say you're on the side of a highway and you're shooting through some fence. Here's a little tip for that. Bonus. Okay, so let's say you have an assignment or something where you have to shoot through a fence line, whether it's at an airport, you're on an overpass on a highway, wherever the case is. Here's a great way to use depth of field to get rid of that fence line. What I'm going to try to do to knock out my fence here by using a shallow depth of field is I'm going to get up close to the fence line, try to aim between the lines here of metal, and I'm going to focus and zoom in on the playground. Right now I'm on an f11, so I have a great depth of field, and I'm going to close my iris, or open my iris, and see how that kind of knocks out the lines of the metal. And so that's one way I can use a shallow depth of field to help clean up my photo better. That sun just got really bright on me. So anyway, that is a quick look into depth of field. A little disclaimer, so there's no confusion. Your f-stop, your iris, and your aperture are all the same thing. Just for some reason, they call them three different things. I don't know how that came up, but I know I was kind of jumping back and forth between the three. But one of my favorite things that you can do to help change your depth of field is using the shutter speed. And so with that is, I didn't go into it in this video, but if you turn your shutter speed on, and you go to maybe 1,000, depending on the lighting conditions, that will have to let less light in to your camera. So you have to use a wider aperture iris, and so that'll make your depth of field even more narrow. So that's one of my favorite little tricks. But I do like depth of field. I use it all the time, depending on the situation that I want. If I want to go wide for an interview, or go tight and blur out everything in the foreground or the background, whatever the case is. But any questions, concerns, comments, please leave them in the comments section. Please like, share, and subscribe. My name is Bill Medicke. You've been watching TV Photoc Tips. Hope to see you in the next video. Thanks much. Good luck and have fun. More shallow depth of field. I don't field. Otherwise, you can turn that up to maybe 11 or crank it to 11.
You can see.
Yeah.
The numbers all go to 11. Look.
And you have a greater depth of field. Got that? I hope I got it right, because this is my third attempt trying to say this.